All right, Steve, my first question for you today says this. If God has a will for my life, how much free will do I have? In other words, how much choice do I have and still be in the Lord's will for my life? That's the question.
Well, and still be in the Lord's will? I mean, you know, it kind of depends on what you mean by being in the Lord's will.
I think their flavor is how much choice do they have if God has the will set?
Yeah. You know, the Bible talks about the perfect will of God, and that leaves the implication of the permissive will of God. I'll give you a verse here.
Okay.
This is out of Romans chapter 12, and it says, "Do not be conformed to this world." This is 12:2, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove or test or understand what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. And so obviously, God has something that he would like me to be doing at every moment of the day. And so there's going to be a constant choice between doing what the Lord would have me do and doing what I feel like doing at the moment. And so I don't want people to get all flipped out about that whole thing, but God's got a purpose and a plan for my life. That the Bible says that I need to plug into. Here's another one. This is in Ephesians chapter 2. Starting in verse 8, it says, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It's the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast." And then he says this, "For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them." And so God has these things that he has prepared me for. It's a area that he wants me to walk in. And basically, as a Christian, what I'm supposed to be doing is plugging into the things that God has me here for. Check this out. This is another one. This is in Philippians. And in Philippians chapter 3, it says, this is in verse 12, Paul talks about the fact that he wants to know the power of Jesus' resurrection, the fellowship of his sufferings, and be conformed to his death. And then he says this, "Not that I've already attained or am already perfected, but I press on that I may lay hold of that for which Christ Jesus has also laid hold of me." And it's the idea that Jesus grabbed me for something. And so what Paul's saying is, I want to grab onto what Jesus grabbed me for. And so there's this whole concept of God has a purpose and a plan for my life. And he's already got it figured out. He knows the end from the beginning. And all I have to do is plug into that. But that's where my will comes in. And so if I was living God's will perfectly, then I'd be a sinless man. I'd be doing everything that God wants me to at every moment of time. And the battle that we have is a battle between my flesh and the Spirit. And when I'm walking in the Spirit, I'm in the place where God can communicate with me easily, because he can communicate to me when I'm in my flesh too. But he can, you know, there's a oneness that's taken place there, and it's a whole lot easier to move in the area of God's will, because he's constantly speaking to us about things, you know, guiding us in different areas. And all we have to do is be sensitive to that. On the other hand, if I'm constantly out to do my own thing, then I'm going to find myself at loggerheads with the will of God in certain areas, and God's going to have to get my attention. And so, you know, one of the things with doing the will of God in a believer's life is the idea of becoming more sensitive to the moving of the Holy Spirit and to conviction and to hearing the voice of God and moving in the direction that God wants you to go. There's a passage in the book of Isaiah that says that we'll hear a voice saying to us, "This is the way, walk in it." And that's what's key to being a follower of Jesus. We're really followers of Jesus. We're not just guys that, you know, Jesus, you know, sent a letter to and said, you know, follow the letter. We don't follow the letter. We follow the Lord. And so, I think that's what needs to happen. God having a will does not mean that God's will is done. And so when we pray in the Lord's Prayer, it's actually the disciples' prayer, but we call it the Lord's Prayer. And he said, one of the first things that we're supposed to be praying is that God's will would be done on earth as it is in heaven. Well, we know that God's will in heaven is done immediately and perfectly. That's the way that it's supposed to be. And the fact that we need to be praying for that lets you know that it's not being done immediately and perfectly here on the earth, and we're praying for that to take place. And not just in the world, not just in, you know, in the people who are around us, but us ourselves. I want God's will to be done in my life. And so a lot of that has to do with listening up and paying attention to what the Lord may be, where the Lord may be moving you, and just being sensitive to the moving of the Spirit.
Okay, so I have a question. This is just kind of my brain work, so I'm going to give you two extremes. Mm-hmm. When you talk about prayer, I've heard you say, you know, whether it's pray without ceasing or without me, you can do nothing type of stuff. Is it you don't just pray for the big stuff, you know, like a car, mm-hmm. or a house or a wife. Everyone, well, mm-hmm. people tend to pray for that kind of stuff. But it's also the small stuff that we need God's help in. And yeah. So I've heard people say, how far does that go as, in the sense of, do you pray like, am I going to Taco Bell or Wendy's, God? What do I eat for lunch? All the way to people saying, well, as long as your heart is in the right place, you know, it doesn't matter whatever ministry you're going to start, whatever, God knows, and he's going to honor that because you're at least trying. So one extreme is like, as long as you're going for it. And the other one is you have to pray for literally every minute detail. Is there a free will thing in the middle of that that's combined with what you're talking about?
Well, I think, I mean, that's the way that I run my life is I don't think that God necessarily cares what pair of socks I put on in the morning.
Right.
But he might. Mm-hmm. And if he does, can he tell me that? And if he tells me that, am I willing to go there?
So are you saying just be aware of what he's telling you?
Yeah, that's it. You know, I'm walking with Jesus, and you know, Jesus goes, okay, let's go. We're going to work, right? I mean, if he was there, it's time to go to work, Steve, get up, go to work. Okay, Lord. Obviously I need to get dressed. I'm getting dressed. And he goes, hey, not the black socks, put on the white socks. In fact, put on one white sock and one black sock. Okay. And I go, why? And he goes, just do it. You know, and if he was there, I go, I don't get you, but okay. And I would do it. And you know, God can do stuff like that. And, you know, maybe I'm walking on the way to work and God speaks to some guy and points out the weird guy with the white sock and the black sock on and says, I want you to go talk to that guy, you know, gets him over to me so that I can share the gospel with him. I have no idea what God's doing. And so I'm never going to be in the position, at least me, I'm never going to be in the position where God is telling me every single part of the plan every single day, that kind of thing. I am just obligated to be open to what the Lord wants to do. And so, yeah, I think that there's a middle ground there. I don't need to be paralyzed by whether or not I go to Wendy's or Taco Bell. Mm-hmm. But if I think, you know, I think I'm going to go to Taco Bell, and then I'm on the way there and, you know, I just don't have peace about it. And it's like, you know, there's something in me that says, you know, thou shalt go to China Cafe. Well, that could be more than my belly. I like China Cafe. And so that could be more than my belly. You know, it could be the Lord. And maybe I'm going to have an appointment with somebody. And so I just need to be open to him. And I don't get paralyzed by that kind of stuff. But I've been following the Lord long enough to know that When there's something hinky going on, as far as, you know, I don't feel like I should leave now, or I think I need to go to this place or that place. A lot of times, what God's doing is he's moving me in a certain direction because I'm about to have an appointment with somebody. There was a really weird thing that God did with me when I was first married. I had a motorcycle, and I had an appointment that I needed to get to, and I was going to ride my bike there. And I went looking for my keys, and I could not find them. And like literally for an hour. And this isn't just, you know, male pattern blindness, you know, on my part. Literally for like an hour, I looked for my keys, and I looked on my dresser, had to be four or five times. And after the hour was up, after about an hour, I went back into the bedroom, looked one more time, and they're sitting right flat on the top of my dresser, right in plain sight where my keys to my motorcycle. And I was like, what in the world was that? What is that? How? And there's no way I could have missed it. And I was like, what is going on? And it's like God was blinding my eyes or something. And I still don't know to this day what was going on. I think it's one of those things that I'm going to be asking the Lord. But I can tell you, you know, having, this is in Southern California, having driven a motorcycle in Southern California, good chance that God was protecting me from death. Mm. You know, and so I think that God moves in a believer's life to get them in the right place and to protect them and that kind of thing. There have been a number of times when I just powered through on something when I felt like I shouldn't. And in the end, I ended up regretting it and then looking back on it and going, God, was that you telling me not to? Was that you telling me to stop? And I think a lot of times it was. And so I just try to be open to the Lord and allow him to do what he wants to do in my life. And so, again, back to the original question, the fact that God has a purpose and a plan for my life, number one, does not mean that it's going to happen, because I have to be willing to go there. And the reason for that is because even though God has a will for me, that doesn't mean that I'm going to fulfill it. And so I'm able to thwart the will of God. God allows it. And so I have a free will, and God has a plan. And God allows me to go the way that I want to. And the choices that I make matter. They matter. And so that's why the Bible's clear on the fact that we need to be close to God. We need to be seeking him. There's one verse after another about the fact that we need to be seeking the Lord and we need to be hearing from him. And the reason, again, is because we want to be in the middle of God's plan. We want to be right in the place where God wants us. If I was able to do everything that God wanted me to, if I was able to do the will of God perfectly, if I had perfect vision, perfect hearing as far as the spiritual things go, then I would be perfect, because that's how God's plan is. And the problem always comes in, comes down to I'm fallen and I have a problem meeting up with that whole thing. But again, that's the plan that God has. He's got the perfect family. He's got the perfect job. He's got the perfect life. He's got the perfect ministry, and I can do what he wants, or I could do what I want. Mm-hmm. And every time that it's been a choice between what he wants and what I want, I've been reticent about that whole thing. I've started out having an attitude, and then in the end, seeing what God did and just went, never mind.
It usually comes down to a faith thing, but there's so many things like that where, and sometimes some of that stuff has even been a decade later where finally God showed me the answer and I was like, thank you, Lord, that you made me listen to you.
Yeah.
Because it's so much better than what I would have
yep.
ended up choosing or whatever.
Yep, absolutely.
Are you good on that?
Yeah.